KNMI geeft code oranje af.
Extreme wateroverlast in Limburg.
De hagelbui van gisteravond zorgde voor flinke schade.
We are starting to feel the consequences of climate change. And this is reflected in extreme weather.
That's why now there is a need for development of the network of high resolution radars for meteorological observations.
So we need to have much better forecasting models, nowcasting models, weather forecast models, climate models. We need this.
FARA is a completely new instrument for investigation of processes in the clouds and precipitations. One of the mysteries which we would like to solve is to find out what exactly happens with the ice crystal in the cloud, how they develop themselves.
How they grow on the way down and how they transform into raindrops. Well, these are very detailed processes. They happen at the scale of 1 micrometer, 1 centimeter. Well, if you look at the standard weather radars, they operate at 500-600 meters. So you cannot see these small phenomena.
That is why FARA will be designing and built in such a way that it will provide resolution in space on unprecedented level. The standard meteorological radar works with a single beam. In FARA, we shall synthesize dozens of beams which will look in different directions.
It will give us snapshots with high repetition rate, which will enable us to really follow this process in much more detail and see the changes in this air parcel. Well, this process is coupled with not only the microphysics, condensation, evaporation, but also dynamics, the turbulence in there. And these processes are very fast. They happen very fast. The traditional radars, they move slowly. And within 2 scans of, let's say, 5 minutes, the process, the cloud has changed too much already.
FARA will be capable to do such a scan within 15 to 20 seconds, providing three-dimensional picture of the rain in the similar area as it's shown here, but also with information how the rain develops on different height. This type of the data are not available in the whole world, and that is why we foresee really breakthrough in the cloud physics, in atmospheric physics, by usage of data coming from FARA.
What this means in the end, our weather models, climate models, atmospheric models, and they will be much more detailed than they currently are. And that's necessary, because if you want to have a short-term weather forecast, so what can I expect 1 hour from now? What can I expect 2 hours from now? And certainly when it's extreme rainfall, well, you need to be precise, you need to be accurate. Well, TARA will give this to us.
We do expect that in 5 years, TARA will be operational and will start to provide data for the users. And there are multiple aspects why FARA is so important. The first aspect is solving several technological challenges to build this instrument. The second is important that providing data to our colleagues from the area of cloud physics, but also water management. And the third is training of a new generation of specialists who can work with phased arrays with active electronically steered antenna systems, because these specialists are needed in future communication system, 6G. They are very much needed for remote sensing from space. They are needed also for future automotive radar and many other areas. And at the moment, there is no any experimental facilities in Europe where the specialists could be trained.
So in the end, we have to learn how to use the instrument, because this is a completely new type of way of looking at the atmosphere.